Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another Quasi Contemplates. Today we're taking a look at Stardew Valley, a Chucklefish published game that I've actually had access to for at least a few weeks. I have about 40 hours in this game now. I was in the alpha beta test. I don't know. Anyway, I played quite a bit of this. It's a pretty fun game. Published by one dude, Concerned Ape, or it's published by Chucklefish, but it was completely done by one dude, Concerned Ape. He's been spending all of his time on this labor of love. It's pretty fun. I enjoy it. This is my first. This is a game that's like. Here, I'm just gonna jump in here. This is a game that's like it's compared often to something like. Harvest Moon, is that the right one? Harvest Moon or Animal Crossing? I haven't played either of those games, so this is kind of my first experience with this kind of genre. I have quite a bit of time in this game though. I have like 40 hours, as I said. So it's a farming. You know, you do a farm. I have like sprinklers set up. Right now it's the middle of winter, so you won't really see any crops. These are like winter seeds. I got some, you know, chickens over here. You can, you know, talk to them. They're pretty cute. My cat should be somewhere around here. This is a game focused around, you know, you grow crops and you can sell them to the thing. You know, I could sell this, whatever, just as an example. You collect lots of different things. You can chop down trees, you know, clear out your farm. You inherit this farm from your grandfather. I've not planned this at all. I just want to showcase this game because it is extremely engaging and but yeah, no, I've been slowly clearing this farm ever since I inherited this farm from my grandfather who died. Now we are into my third like season here. There's tons of stuff to do. There's this huge open world. Maybe not open, but it's gigantic. I don't know, the world is gigantic. There's different crafting stuff, right? Collect stuff, you craft it. There's fishing. There's a whole bunch of different skills, I guess, would be how I would describe it. Where the heck are my skills? Right here. So there's, you know, you got farming and mining and foraging and fishing, and as you level these up, they become more and more effective, and you get like certain perks at level 5 and level 10 that you get to choose between. So there's kind of a focus on, or there's some RPG elements, right? There's fishing. I'll just catch a fish really fast, easy every time. Come on, baby. There you go. Fishing mini games, lots of different stuff to collect there. One of the goals in this game is to fill out it's called the community center. And you do this by, you know, collecting different. Like I've collected a peach and an apricot. I gotta get some jelly or goat cheese or whatever to fill this out, and then you get rewards for completing these. And there's, you know, it's cool. There's also a ton of. I'm just gonna walk around the world as I do this. The art style in this game is absolutely fantastic. I love it a lot. You know what? It's almost 9 o'clock. There's a day-night cycle. That's incredibly important to the gameplay because you know the NPCs are doing different things at different times of the day, and everybody has like a weekly schedule, and you can give people gifts to make them like you more. That you can get married in this game. There's like 5 bachelors and 5 bachelorettes, as I recall. But yeah. So that's, you know, it's just a game about, there's a ton of things that you can do, right? You could devote yourself entirely to fishing all of the fish in the sea. There's legendary fish, you know. Or you could go for collecting, you know, all of the all of the things in the... Actually, here, I can show that right now. There's a museum, right? And you can collect all sorts of baubles and whatnot, special minerals and things that you mine and stuff, and I don't think I have anything right now yet. But there's a ton of stuff at this. This is the museum. Ancient doll. You know, I've never actually read these, but they... Yeah, and you can, you know, you can sort your stuff. I've not done nearly with that. That's gonna take a while longer, I think, to get done, but you get rewards for completing that. So also, you upgrade your tools. You can process geodes. What you got? I think I already have that. Jasper. Yeah, so that's an example of a thing that I would give to the dude. Let me go. Another fairly large aspect of this game is the mines. And actually, hold on. Check my quarry. So this is a place that you unlock later in the game where you can, like these rocks respawn or whatever. You know, you can come here every couple days and a bunch of new rocks will spawn, and sometimes you'll get like special ore veins. These worms, this is how you dig up rusty cogs. See, that's an artifact that I've never had before, but whenever there's worms, you can also just dig normally with your hoe, but you know, the worms tell you where there is guaranteed to be a drop, occasionally. But occasionally you can get, if you, yeah, like that, there's some clay. You have an energy bar. Doing most actions in the game causes you to lose energy. You can refill it, by eating, you know, forage or crops. So this is the mines. In the mines, you go down, floor at a time, and, there's monsters, and you can, you know, there's rocks. It's kind of a randomly generated every time thing, and, you know, we can get some gold ore, which you can use for crafting and or just sell, etc. There's a whole bunch of different ores and stuff. There's also enemies, and there's none on this floor, but maybe we'll see some over here, yeah. When you go down into the mines, you have a health bar as well. That's right here. If either your health or your energy run out, you're kind of screwed. You get like knocked out, and you lose some of your items. I think if your health runs out, you lose items, and if your energy runs out, I don't know. There's the doctor in town. Oh Jesus, it's fine. Doctor in town charges you a small fee for having you not be dead anymore. But anyway, yeah, so there's different levels of the mines, and as you get to certain milestones, you get, you can travel to them, and there's rewards at the end of every couple stages. So, that does have an end, but there's also, there's a desert thing that I haven't... There's a lot of unlocks in this game, and one of the things that I think I haven't unlocked is like an endless dungeon style thing. Maybe I should go check out some of the NPCs. Maybe we have some people running around. The NPCs in this game are all incredibly... they all have their own personalities, and you can give them gifts that suit their tastes and kind of find out when, you know, what they like and stuff. This is the community center. This is the thing that we're trying to restore, kind of one of the main objectives. I've already restored, like, the craft room, and I think I did another one, because I have two stars. I think one of them was bugged for me because I had an early alpha version or an early beta version, but that's unimportant. It's fixed now. Maybe it was this room. Yeah, no, that one's fixed too. Okay, it's not bugged. My bad. So yeah, but things like collecting different types of fish. I still need a catfish for this one. I need some night fishing stuff, and when you complete all these, you get this glittering boulder removed, and who knows what that does? I have no clue. There's like big milestones things. The other thing, Oh, the desert bus, I think, was the... That might actually be the one that gets you to the mines. Hello, this is like Abigail, I think. Yeah. So you can give her a gift. I could either give her, like, you know, a piece of copper or a piece of wood or, you know, literally anything, basically. And she will, you know, give her some holly. You bought me a present, thanks! It's like a flower, so she's like, okay, yeah. Or we could come over here and we could give a piece of wood to, you know, someone in the general shop. Oh, what the heck is going on here? Aerobics class. I didn't even know that existed. We'll give this dude... Well, I guess it's the thought that counts. Yeah. Freaking piece of wood. Here's some copper. Oh, please never bring this to me again. Yeah. All right. So this is the store where you buy different things. Because it's winter, normally you would buy seeds here because it's winter. This is like a yoga class. What the heck? Or aerobics or something. I didn't know I could go in here, actually. Hello, Quaza. Let me out. Okay. Just, like, chapel over here. The art in this game is absolutely superb. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're all talking about their... stuff. But yeah, you can, like, give people treats and... Can't go in her room. Oh my god, she's playing the game from the bar. Oh my god. I never noticed that. Okay, there's also just a bunch of hidden things everywhere. So there's, like, daily quests. You can get some money and some fame, or favor, fame. The bar. Hello, Leah. Here, take this. Leah likes, that's Pren's waifu. What is she doing behind the bush? Okay. That's Pren's waifu, so I'm trying to, you know, steal her away from Pren's. I don't want a Joja Cola. Whoa! I've never played this one. Okay, so this is a mini game that you can do at the bar. Excuse me, friend. It's basically like, you know, you kill things, you move on. There's power-ups. It's pretty entertaining. Supposedly there's a thing that you get for completing it, like all the way, which is fairly difficult, actually. And there are multiple levels and upgrades and things. Pretty just nifty, random things. I'm gonna go ahead and get out of there, because I don't want to actually do this. I've never played this one. What is this? How do I... What? Oh. Okay. Yeah, I've never seen this before just now. I don't know if I did something to unlock this. I must have done something to unlock this. Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Okay, I thought it would land on there, but that's okay. I did, in fact, not land on there. Can I go faster? But yeah, random minigame. Oh my god! I tried to jump! Freaking... Oh god! I'm dead! No, we're alive. We're alive. Just live. Oh no! I've died. Okay. yeah. Alright. Well, that's that. But yeah, so it's getting to be late now at this point, and, I've done basically nothing, but that's okay. Just the fishing dude. There's also cool, like, events and stuff. Each of these dudes has a birthday, and you can give them gifts on their birthday, and then there's, like, special events. Every now and then you can check the calendar over here. Excuse me. There we go. So, people's birthday, and then there's the Feast of the Winter Star. We just did the Festival of Ice, which was, like, an ice fishing tournament, and I won, because I'm amazing, and, cool stuff all over. You can also build, there's like a big part of the game is like building different, you know, filling out your farm, right? And you can build, make your house better. I have the worst house right now. I have not focused on upgrading my house at all. But you can get more silos and more, you know, chicken coops and build stuff. You hire one of the NPCs to She's the carpenter. I don't know if she's... Yeah, she's not here right now because it's late. But, you know? To fill out... You can even get, like, horses and stuff. There's, like, really... and cows and, you know, all sorts of animals and stuff. But then, at the end of the day, you... oh, there's a book. Read that at the library. But yeah. I don't know what this is. There's lots of stuff that I haven't yet discovered. This game is like a very long-term investment of time that you'll be spending if you end up playing it. It's very engaging. Hello, Puck. Here's my cat. But yeah, also my farm isn't very pretty, and that's not just because it's winter, that's because I'm lazy mainly. You can make stone pathing and fancy walls around your stuff and make your stuff look really pretty, but I have not yet done that. I have this super cucumber, that's about all I have to my name. It's amazing. That's a fish that I got at one point. I should probably, it's like 8:30. I mean, you can go and, like, you know, do other stuff at night, but eventually it gets too late and you have to go back to sleep. So we deposited this forage into the thing, we made a little bit of money. At the end of every day, all of the stuff that you throw into that box, including, like, crops and things that you find and any gems that you find in the mines or whatever, that all turns to liquid cash money. But yeah. So that's Stardew Valley in a nutshell. This game has like a ton of... You can do all sorts of stuff, man. It's extremely, extremely in-depth. Lots of content. And, a very dedicated, developer. It's a great game. I've been playing like a lot more of this than I should. Oh, dude, there's, like, freaking worms in here everywhere. I'm gonna ignore these slimes. Why are there so many worms in here? Oh, they're all giving me clay. Give me, like, yeah, there you go. Collection items. So many worms here. What? It's, like, the most worms I've ever seen. Got 40 hours in this game. There's two books on the ground. What the heck? Yeah, anyway. Are there worms down here? Oh. Where is that slime going? What the heck? Get out of here. There isn't, like, armor that you can wear. I mean, well, there sort of is. You get... The only real armor is, like, boots. The boots are the defense upgrade. And there's also two ring slots and a hat slot. The hat slot is something that you get from achievements. There's the wizard tower. There's a wizard inside it. He's an okay guy. I don't like walking all the way out here, so I don't have very much friendship with him. There's different fish depending on where you fish, also. Like lakes or streams or whatever. Get down here, you can get some nifty hats. I have this watermelon headband. These are, you know... the things that you get for having certain achievements in game. But yeah. So I think that's pretty much it. There's like tons of stuff that I have yet to... Wow, these books! Oh my god! In the winter, you know, it's not very exciting in terms of crops and stuff, but or forage for that matter. Like, walking around here, you can get, you know, randomly spawned, this is an extremely good, well-timed example. You can get, you know, forage items that are good. There's hidden areas that you can unlock with all sorts of nice features. There's an NPC in here. Shh, secrets. And all sorts of cool stuff. I think that's about it. That's all I got. That's Stardew Valley. It's $14.99. on Steam. And it's well worth it, I think. I think you can definitely get your money's worth out of this, no matter how you slice it. Yeah. That's all she wrote. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, hit the like button. Check out this game. It's on Steam. It just came out. It's pretty awesome. Let me see. My cat is dead. Rip my cat, though. Shit! It's fine. Don't worry about it. Mutant carp. It's all my stuff shoved into chests. I'm sure people more organized than me can make this stuff look a lot better, but I don't know, man. That's okay. How are my trees doing? I have some fruit trees planted down here. I've cleared out all this farm area, but I still have a ton. This area that you can farm in is pretty huge. This is all my land that I could chop down all these trees if I had the energy to and the motivation to. It's pretty good. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed, I'll hope to see you back again. Enjoy the game. Bye-bye.